physician Joshua Caldrena will give you some information about the two of the greatest contributors in the field of mathematics. I know a place where I can ask certain students if they know about the two mathematicians, Johannes Kepler and Apollonius, in Dr. Francisco L. Calingasan Memorial Colleges Foundation Incorporated. So we are here now at Dr. Francisco L. Calingasan Memorial Colleges Foundation Incorporated. So I will interview certain students if they know about Johannes Kepler and Apollonius. So let's go inside and let's ask them. So, are you familiar with Johannes Kepler and Apollonius?
Yes, I know about... I'm not familiar with Johannes Kepler, but I know about Apollonius, who contributes in geometry.
Great. Sir, I'm Christian Joshua Caldre, and would you allow me to ask you some questions? So, are you familiar with Johannes Kepler and Apollonius?
Yes, as far as I know, Johannes Kepler and Apollonius was a great contributor in the field of mathematics in their time, also in our present time.
So, thank you, sir. Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon.
I'm Christian Joshua Caldre. Would you allow me to ask you some questions? Okay. So, are you familiar with Johannes Kepler and Apollonius?
Apollonius. I'm not that familiar with him, but I'm familiar with the one, Johannes Kepler.
Okay, who's Johannes Kepler?
As far as I'm concerned, Johannes Kepler made a great contribution in the field of mathematics. Naturally, proposed three laws, in which the first law is all about the orbits of the planets and so
on. Thank you, ma'am. Mathematician Apollonius of Perga was known as the great geometer. He influenced the development of analytic geometry and substantially advanced mechanics, navigation, and astronomy. He also the last mathematician of antiquity and born at Perga in Pamphylia, Southern Asia Minor. Apollonius had Euclid's great collection, The Elements. He wrote the book called The Conics. And the first part of the book is about elementary introduction. Apollonius was also known as a great astronomer in the Almagest, the great astronomical work by Ptolemy. Apollonius mentioned as having proved two important theorems. These theorems dealing with epicycles and eccentric circles enabled the points on the planetary orbits to be determined where the planets, as seen from the Earth, appeared stationary. Now let's talk about Johannes Kepler. Johannes Kepler was born in December 27, 1571 and died on November 15, 1630. Johannes Kepler was born as child of Protestant parents. He had six siblings, three of which died already at an early age. In 1604, he wrote a report on a supernova, watched by himself, and worked on the Astronomia Nova, in which he wrote down his result about the orbit of planet Mars. In 1609, this work was published in Kepler's first two laws of planetary motion. Kepler's first law, the orbits of the planets are ellipses, with the sun of one focus of the ellipse. Kepler's second law, the line joining the planet to the sun sweeps out equal areas in equal times as the planet travels around the ellipse. And the third law, the ratio of the squares of the revolutionary periods for two planets is equal to the ratio of the cubes of their semi-major axis. And that is all about Johannes Kepler and Apollonius. Hope you understand and thank you for watching. Do. about Johannes Kepler and Apollonius. Hope you understand and thank you for watching.
Yes!
Yes! Tama naman siya, ikaw! Yes! Ikaw! Ikaw! May my friend! Ito'y pa yun!
Go next!
Sir, I would like to say hi to my relatives there in New York. I promise you.
Sir!